Hello guys, I'm Ellie and today we're making bubble bars. Now there are a lot of videos out there that teach you how to make bubble bars, but most of them are showing you how to create the ones with the little, you know, spirals in the center. And although I think they're really, really cool, there are so many out there, so I just thought I might show you something a little bit different. These ones here are the ones that I'm showing you how to make today. I decided to do mine pink, but you can totally customize this. So anyway guys, let's get on with the video.
So to make these bubble bars, all that you will need is 10.1 ounces of baking soda, also known as bicarbonate of soda in some places, 7.4 ounces of cream of tartar, do not get this confused with tartaric acid, they are different things, 2.7 ounces of corn flour or cornstarch, 5.8 ounces of sodium lauryl sulfur acetate, also known as SLSA. It can irritate your nose sometimes, so I recommend wearing a dust mask. And 0.6 ounces of tapioca starch. Into another bowl, you want to add 7 ounces of glycerin along with 1.8 ounces of coconut oil or any other oil of your choice, such as sunflower oil, sweet almond oil, olive oil, or any other thing like that. Now you need to add some scent to these bubble bars, and I decided to use lemon, cinnamon, and ylang ylang, but you can use whatever oils you'd like. Make sure that you get it all out of your spoon and then you can pour that mixture into the dry ingredients. Mix it well until it doesn't come together anymore and then you can start to use your hands. You're kind of looking for a consistency that's a little bit like dough. That's when you know you've got the mixture right. Then what I'm going to do is separate it into two bowls so I can have two different colors, but you can skip this step. Now you need to add some color to your bubble bars and I'm just using this liquid dye. Now you just need to incorporate that until it's evenly colored throughout the whole mixture and then place that down onto a sheet of baking paper. Now you need to do whatever you can to get this mixture out into a long sausage shape. Then flip over the baking paper and put the white out onto that sheet and do the same. Once you have two sausage shapes, you need to put them together and then just maneuver it around and squeeze it down so that it forms one big log. Cut it into pieces using a sharp knife. I got around 7, but that may change depending on how big you want your bars to be. Take one of them and start to use the palm of your hands to move it so that it forms a cone pyramid shape. Some people may find this to be a little bit of a struggle, but it should be alright and it should work. You can leave it like this, that is totally fine, but I decided to push it down and then taking the top half of a bath bomb mold, I swirled the bubble bar around in it so that it got nice and evenly domed. So once you have this, all that you need to do is let the bubble bars sit out and dry for around 3 to 5 days, it may depend, and then you can use them. So I thought I might show you guys a little bit of a demo. So all that I did was cut my bubble bar in half and then I just broke and crumbled it underneath the running water. Once it was all in the tub, I turned the water pressure up as high as it could go and then, as you can see here, the bubbles just grew and grew and grew and pretty much took over my whole tub. Now the color of the water of mine was a really, really nice pink, but that will depend on how much food coloring you use and what colors you choose.
So that's all for this week's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and comment below any other ideas for videos you have. Anyway, guys, I love you all. Thank you for watching. Bye.